If you could just have an open spiritual eyes to see from the inside out, from the beginning and from the end and to the end of your situation, you would probably know the right step to take and will have more confidence in God, and you won't have to worry much. Hello, I'm Art Velasquez, and this is the Words of Hope. Welcome and good morning. Our topic today is about the eye of our understanding. And we are saying, open my eyes, O Lord. I am sure some of us will be wondering why we need God to open our eyes when we haven't closed them, or when we are not blind. I believe that God has given us physical eye to see in the physical realm, and He can give us spiritual eyes to see in the spiritual realm. Ephesians chapter 1 verse 18 says, "The eyes of your understanding being enlightened, that you may know what is the hope of His calling, and what the riches of the glory of His inheritance in the saints." The above verse is an indication that there is another eye that is totally different from our natural eyes. The verse also elaborated more on the need to have our eyes of understanding enlightened so that we may know the hope of His calling. This tells us that many of us have been called without knowing the hope of His calling. Romans chapter 8:28 made us underrated that people are called according to the purpose of God. My question is this: do you know the purpose for which you have been called by God? I believe you can know this if the eyes of your understanding is open. What is spiritual eyes? A spiritual eye is the eye that sees spiritual realities. The natural eye sees natural realities, but there is more to life than the natural realities we see around us. I believe one of the challenges most believers are facing today is that of spiritual blindness, which is our inability to see spiritual things. Some of us may be going through circumstances that needs divine intervention, but we don't seem to be getting anywhere with our concerns because we cannot see any solution at the moment. If God can open our eyes to see from the inside out, the beginning and the end of our situation, we will know the right step to take, and we will have more confidence in Him, and we won't have to worry much. Spiritual blindness is like you have been in total darkness and not been aware of the situation around us spiritually. In the book of 2 Kings chapter 6 verse 17, Elisha prayed that God should open the eyes of his servant to see the angels surrounding them, and God did, and the servant put his trust and hope in God. The servant couldn't see beyond his limitation until God opened his eyes, or his spiritual eyes. We are like that servant in the Bible. We are not able to see beyond our physical eyes. We just see what we have in front of us. Sometimes it's hard to see reasons behind situation, particularly situations that are unfair and awkward. We can't rationalize everything, and yet everything comes and has a reason in which we are sometimes dull to understand. We need the eyes of our understanding to be enlightened so that we can look beyond and see the whole picture. The entirety, not just the fraction of it, no matter how broad the spectrum might be, we need God to open our eyes so that we can see. In the book of Numbers 22 verses 1 to 39, there is a story that we read about how Balak invited Balaam to come and curse the people of Israel. Balak knew that Balaam is one of the powerful prophets in his time, and whatsoever he cursed shall be cursed. As God did not want Balaam to go and curse the people because they have been blessed by God, He sent His angels to change the direction of Balaam's donkey to prevent him from going to Balak. The donkey was going in the direction of God, but Balaam could not understand why the donkey was going in that direction, because Balaam was experiencing spiritual blindness. Until God finally opened the spiritual eyes of Balaam, that he saw the angel that was directing the donkey to another direction. This shows that no matter how long we have been to be a believer in the Lord, no matter how much scripture we know, no matter how many miracles we have performed, and no matter what our position and title is, it is still possible for us to experience spiritual blindness. We need the guidance of God so that we could see beyond our physical ability and see the spiritual things, and we could cooperate with God and be able to evade the consequences of wrong decisions. There are reasons why do we need our spiritual eyes open. Number one is for direction. This can be physical direction or direction before taking a decision regarding career, marriage, jobs, churches, or friendship, and many more vital decisions in life. Secondarily, we need our eyes to be open to pray a specific prayer, a targeted prayer. Once our spiritual eyes is open, we will be able to pray the right prayer for the right situation. Thirdly is to see new opportunities. It is possible to be surrounded by great opportunities without seeing them, just like Hagar in the book of Genesis chapter 21, verse 15 to 19. Hagar was surrounded by a well of water, but until God opened her eyes, he couldn't see it. We are most of the time surrounded by unknown opportunities, and yet we are not capable of seeing them. When we pray for an open eye, we are able to see beyond our physical eye can see. Fourthly, is to reveal the scheme of the enemy against us. It will be a good thing to see the secret or the schemes of the enemy so we can pray a specific targeted prayer against it. Fifthly, we have to pray for an open eye to see the wonder-working power of God. You see, God is working for us even when we don't know it. Psalms 119, verse 18. Sixthly, to build our hope in God. God opened the eyes of Elisha's servant, and his hope and confidence in God was risen. So are we. When we pray for our eyes to be opened to the things of God, we can be able to see that God is for us and never against us. There are consequences of spiritual blindness. Number one is the possibility of wasted effort and stagnancy. Number two is failure and missed opportunities. Number three is possibility of praying amiss. Number four is possibility of going towards the wrong direction. Number five is lost of hope. Number six is possibility of making wrong decision. But you will see that the causes of spiritual blindness are only two. God can decide to open or not to open our spiritual eyes so we can see or we cannot see. And secondarily, the sin can also cause our spiritual eye to be blind, just like Balaam. But what we need to do is we need to pray to God to open our spiritual eyes to see. We need to obey God and stay away from sin. Meditate on the Word of God, as Hosea chapter 4, verse 6 says. Please give your life to Jesus if you have not yet done so by confessing your sins to God and believe in the awesome power of His resurrection. I believe one of the greatest desires of a believer is to have our spiritual eyes open. It will be a great prayer to ask God to open our spiritual eyes as soon as we give our life to Jesus, or as soon as we realize we are spiritually blind, so that we may know the hope and the purpose of our calling and experience the riches of the glory of His inheritance. I believe you have it and receive it in Jesus' name. Be blessed and be joyful in living this life for Christ. Live a life with an eye to see through Jesus Christ our Lord. That eyes can see beyond our physical eyes. God bless you for now. Shalom.